I feel kind of bad that the Heat still had to play last night's game with only 8 players, but Adam Silver kind of did the Sixers dirty last week. Anyway, Philly took 2 for Miami and dropped the Heat off last night. As always, this starts with the offensive playbook. You know me, bro. Let's talk about it.
We've seen Point Joe run the floor a few times, but Danny Green knows what's coming, so he gets up out of there. This 3 shooters around the perimeter, 1 in the dunker spot look has been the blueprint for the offense the entire season. And it's not complicated. Break the game down to man-on-man matchups and let your playmakers go to work in space. Come on, fam, you know what we call that here. Dog food. And Philly tries to achieve this look with more than 1 player. 3 beyond the arc, 1 in the dunker, and a whole bunch of space for Tobias to exploit a mismatch. Weight room, yes sir! But a massive staple in Philadelphia's offense this season is the 2-man game. Simply put, this breaks a 5-on-5 basketball game down into a 2-on-2 game. You'll notice that every other defender is occupied, so the 2-man game gives the ball handler and the screener an entire side of the floor to work on. Because of it, Philadelphia is top 10 in pull-up field goal attempts this season, whereas they were bottom 8 last year. And just as it's responsible for generating pull-up opportunities, it's also propelled Philadelphia in the top 8 league-wide for drives, whereas last year they were bottom 8. This is the perfect complement for Philadelphia's offense as they have numerous ball handlers that do their damage getting downhill. For example, Shake Milton had 31 points last night and many came compliments of the 2-man game. You see, Shake is tied for the best field goal percentage in the NBA on drives and he's only missed 9 layups this season. So it's as simple as getting this man a screen to get him downhill and letting him take care the rest. Another look Philly is throwing at opponents is double screens. With this look, the first screen is responsible for popping out and the second for rolling to the basket. And when teams sell out to stop the dribble penetration, find the sneaky shooter. The same look for Shake as a ball handler got him free in space to pull up and hit a midi. And just a possession later, the same design got Shake downhill and free in space to get a bucket. Another concept in Philadelphia's offense is off-ball movement. Dwight sets an off-ball for Shake, and as the defense reacts, he sets another for Toby, which led to a clean look. And Philly responded to Miami's 2-3 zone with high post, low post action. Philly works the ball around the perimeter with Joe in the high post. When Maxey penetrates and forces the zone to react, he finds Simmons behind everybody and drops a dime. And again, Philly used the high post, low post look against Miami's zone here. And because the defense makes sure not to lose Simmons this time, Embiid takes matters into his own hands.
Listen, I understand holding players accountable, and Ben is definitely not above the criticism. But a game like this one demonstrates the value that he brings.
3 Miami defenders collapse on Ben driving to the rack, which creates an open catch and shoot look for Toby in the corner. And then directly after that, Ben clamps Ty Hero and forces a turnover. That right there is a tone-setting sequence. When Ben gets under the basket here, there's 5 Miami defenders with their defensive attention on him. And with all these eyes on him, Ben finds an open shooter and delivers a dime from the baseline. As the 2-man game stalls against zone here, Ben gets a head start to get downhill. When he starts to go to the basket, he brings Miami's defense into the paint and draws the attention of 4 defenders. This attention creates a good opportunity for Joe. As soon as the double comes, when Ben is working down low, he finds his man Shake. Miami's defense isn't even back in transition yet. They don't know where their guys are, but they all know they gotta stop Ben. And again, this defensive attention on Ben creates an open 3-point try for Green. Ultimately, Ben only scored 10 points, but he helped account for 50 of them. 9 of his 12 assists were 3-pointers. Altogether, he created 33 points via assists. And all 3 of the steals led to points. Specifically, 2 2-pointers and a 3-pointer.
I feel the same way, big dog.
Watch this, right? Kelly Olynyk spots his man Tobias, and yet he still travels towards the paint to form this wall to prevent a Ben drive. Ben uses this to his advantage and gets Toby a clean look. Here's a prime example of where Ben could shoot, But he's thinking, this dude right next to me is shooting almost 40% there. I'll let him do it. I don't even get how this is possible, okay? Ben fakes a pass to Matisse, looks Iggy off, and makes him go to shake, and then passes back to Matisse, all without traveling. And Simmons has set a career high in assists through 11 games this season.
It's real. Believe the hype, because it's real. Tyrese Maxey and Shake Milton aren't just basketball players. They're hooper hoopers.
Tyrese Maxey averaged 20 points per game over his last 5 games, and this comes in legitimate minutes, not garbage time. He's got the second most total points among rookies, and he's tied for the 4th most steals. He's even got more pick and roll points than CP3, John Wall, and Lou Will. And Shake has been going oh my god, crossed him and lost him. I was saying, Shake has been going crazy too. He's top 10 among rotation players in points per game, total free throws attempted, and steals. The Sixers finally have a good balance of ball handlers on their roster, and these two cats give them a huge offensive punch. Last night, they combined for 46 points on 56% shooting from the floor.
D. Murray and his staff not only nailed the Maxey pick, but also they may have gotten a steal in the second round with Isaiah Joe.
Wait a minute, a foot in front of the logo in Iggy's grill? Okay! He's tied for the 10th most three-pointers made in the NBA over his past 5 games. And he sent Ty Hero, so I'd anticipate more minutes moving forward.
Real briefly, let's look at the defense.
Philly gave up a lot of buckets coming around screens. This takes away the 3 ball, but it gives the ball handler an opportunity to manipulate drop coverage. You'll notice that by the path the defense takes coming around the screen, they're playing on the hip of or behind the player with the ball. This is something that Philadelphia did in previous seasons, and honestly something that a lot of teams around the league do. Things could get a little ugly against teams like Boston or Miami that use a lot of screens to get their guys downhill or free in space. But there is a silver lining though. Philly is holding opposing pick and roll ball handling guards to 37.9% from the field. This is the 4th lowest opposing pick and roll ball handler guard field goal percentage in the NBA. And this is a little better than some of the surrendered percentages of years past. Another positive is that Ben set the tone on defense in this game. He totaled 3 steals and kept Ty Hero bothered for most of the night.
All right, fam, that's it for me. I appreciate you hanging out with me. As always, I'll see you when I see you. Hit me up with a sub, comment below, holler at me on Twitter. Do whatever you gotta do. But most importantly, stay solid, baby. Stay solid, baby! Come on, please.